Tashkent is the capital city of the Republic of Uzbekistan, a country located in the region of Central Asia between the Amudarya and Sirdarya rivers. The city itself is located on the Zarafshan River, just to the west of the Fergana Valley. The history of Tashkent goes back more than 2,500 years, to a time when there was evidence of habitation in the region. The name itself means City of Stone, perhaps indicative of the stones used in its construction. It grew to be a significant stop on the Great Silk Road in the 11th and 12th centuries, yet remained in the shadows of the more important city of Samarkand, which is approximately 300 kilometers to the south. While Samarkand and Bukhara make claims to be a cultural centers of Uzbekistan, Tashkent remains the political and economic power of the country. Moreover, it is a major transportation and trade hub for Central Asia. Centuries of the history of Uzbekistan are easily learned by its applied arts and cultural heritage. Now we will visit State Museum of Applied Arts and Handicraft History of Uzbekistan in Tashkent. Museum is a reserve of collections of a popular decorative art of Uzbekistan. There are more than 7,500 exhibits on display, and in museum's reserve, around 1,000 of them are displayed on exhibition. Different collections of applied arts are demonstrated here: embroidery, embroidered in gold, cloth, fabrics, carpets, printed cloth, ceramics, porcelain, wood painting, wood carving, lacquered miniature, musical instruments, jewelry and chasing.
This building was founded in 1870, and let me introduce our Suhratakya Ibrahimov. He works here, and we can start from first hall. The hall of traditional embroidery, please. In this hall you can see traditional embroidery of our country, which you can see 11 traditional embroidery schools. Before it was the tradition to start embroidery from 5-6 years old. That's why girls started in early childhood, and they should make 10-15 pieces of embroidery till their marriage. So that's why they made suzanis, they made scarves, they made tablecloths, pillowcases. And suzani, the translation of this word from Tajik, suzan means needle, suzani needlework. And as you see, before starting to make suzani, first in wooden loom made the materials. The white was 35 till 50 centimeters. That's why it made of several parts. And several parts made together, then master started to draw this. And they didn't use some paper to the drawing, only by free hands. And after drawing, several women start to make in several hours a day. For example, one family, daughter and two daughters and mother, they could make this kind of suzani during 4-5 months, 5-6 hours a day. And use it before silk threads, which dyed with natural colors. For example, we can say about beige color from onion skin made this kind of color, and green color from the shell of the pomegranate, and red color was from the madroot, and violet color was from the black mulberries. And after making embroidery, usually a master washed them. When they washed it, they didn't change colors, because 100% was the natural colors. And this one, for example, Bukhara embroidery, Bukhara suzani. Second Suzanne is from Nurata. Nurata is one of the largest schools of embroidery in Uzbekistan. And here you can see plant ornaments. And in embroidery, masters uses two stitches. First we call yurma. On first embroidery you can see by hook and by needle made. Yurma is chain stitch. Second is bosma stitch. Bosma is satin stitch. And here also usually they use needle. And you can see in different flowers, different kind of the ornaments, symbolic ornaments. For example, here you can see a pomegranate. Pomegranate is symbol of love, symbol of family, to have many children. And you can see cotton flowers, symbol of the peace of the family. And you can see also almond. Almond was the protection. It protected the family and family members. And the third Suzanne is Shahrisabz Suzanne. Here used more small flowers, small ornaments. And in our hall, you can see the works of 19th, 20th centuries. And in showcases, you can see different kind of the scarves and clothes, which decorated with embroidery. Also in Uzbekistan, there is tradition to leave unfinished parts of Suzanne. This is, for example, from Samarkand. It was tradition, the master wanted that her daughters and granddaughters should be continued her generation and craft also. That's why in each Suzanne, if you search, you can find these unfinished parts. And this is Jizakh. Jizakh is a region of Uzbekistan which is situated between of Samarkand and Tashkent. And in four parts you can see, we call it tumor, which means amulet. It's for protection used. And in some places you can see almond, also for protection. And you can see in our hall clothes with national materials, which produces in Margilan masters. There are four kind of the materials. First, very thin one, we call shoyi. It's 100% silk. And adras. Adras usually used also nowadays using for the clothes of women, 50% silk and 50% cotton. This one is bekasam. It's usually for men used this kind of material. And 80% of cotton and 20% silk. And you can see in showcases from the embroidery, yeah, this kind of skull caps. And looking to the skull cap, people knew from which region man or woman. And here you can see women skull caps. And there is the period of women to wearing skull caps. Till marriage, usually girls wear this kind of silk skull caps. And after marriage, golden skull caps. And after borning the child, scarves which are decorated with embroidery. And you can see from Shahrisabz, Fergana girls wear this kind of Shahrisabz skull caps. That one is from Tashkent, it's middle of the 20th century. And here you can see Lokai skull caps. There were people who lived in this place and wear this kind of circle skull caps. And here you can see skull cap of men. Andijan men wear it skull caps of black background and decorated with silk threads, where you can see almond also. And here Bukhara skull caps, and a little bit higher than Andijan. And this one is Tashkent skull caps. And circle ones, Shahrisabz skull caps, it wear it Fergana men. And colorful one, Surkhandarya, south of Uzbekistan. And this is also ancient one of Shahrisabz. And there is interesting clothes which we call paranji. Paranji, it's usually used for women, to close the figure of the woman. And till 1927, women wear this kind of paranji. And in winter time, it wear it this kind of paranji. And you can see black scarf in the middle. to close the face, and we call it chashim band. From Tajik word, chashim means eyes, band means close. And it made from horse tail. And hand of the paranji, it was symbolic. When it's made together, it means women married. When it's separately, it means women single. That's why looking to the paranji, people knew the situation of the woman. There is a pottery wheel from wood. Before, our masters used this kind of pottery wheel. And what you see in our hall, all the ceramic schools use it and using nowadays this kind of pottery wheel. They turn by foot and they make shapes by hands. And you can see in this showcase ancient ceramic from 3rd and 12th centuries, which founded in Tashkent. And ceramic not far from Bukhara, 40 kilometers from Bukhara. And in this place, it were around 41 ceramic workshops in 1940. But nowadays, only one family is continuing it. And the difference from other schools, the drops on plate, they put in the kiln upside down, and the glaze makes drops, which means made in Gijduvan. And here used six different colors. This is Shahrisabz ceramic school. In Shahrisabz also you can see the bird ornaments, and you can see pomegranate and almond ornaments. Usually not only in ceramic or in embroidery, in all the craft of our country you can meet almond and pomegranate. And only one family also continuing in Shahrisabz. Tashkent ceramic in terracotta style and in glazed style. Rahimov family, it's very famous family. They are also continuing in Tashkent. Some copies of 9th century and some copies of 14th century. In Shahrisabz Muzaffar family, and in Gijduvan Narzulayev family is continuing ceramic schools. And why I'm explaining by schools, by families, because in Rishtan, Fergana Valley, nowadays is a center of ceramics where works around 600 ceramists. And we call it Blue Ceramic of Uzbekistan. Usually you can see more blue and white colors here. And there is special interesting dish which we call sarshoy. It means for hand work, for the washing of head. It made small, special for the showcase, but usually it's bigger. It's for the for women to coloring the hair, to washing the hair. Samarkand ceramic school in terracotta style. And in Samarkand, there are three families are continuing traditional ceramic. And usually you can see dragons, which became from the Great Silk Road in Afrasiab style. Afrasiab is one of the ancient styles of our country. And usually the mouth of dragon should be open. It's also symbolic. It means there are so many kind people in the world. If the mouth is closed, it means it's nobody. And here you can see Samarkand ceramic also, which introduced our Uzbek life and traditions, national sport. For example, we call kurash, which means arm wrestling, chaykhana, usually the place which every month our men make here, they cook plov and they talk each other. Interesting thing, in chaykhana never women come, only men. And here you can see father and children, young family, which is making skull cap and musical instruments playing. Because each man know how to play on musical instrument. Doira, for example, rubab. And here you can see whistles On the 1st of March, we celebrated Nowruz, the Muslim New Year. On this day, the children whistle them, and it calls rain. If it's raining much, the year will be harvest. And it's fantasy and toys. That's why it doesn't look any animal. That's why after making shape, the master makes the line. It means it's not alive. They cut neck. And the next ceramic school is Khwarezm Ceramic School. Usually you can see in Khwarezm Ceramic School glass glaze. And the difference of other schools, the shape of, we call it badia. It's a traditional shape which you can meet only in Khwarezm. It's middle of the bowl and it like a plate. And this is we call chirok, which means oil lamp. And in the next hall, you can see the central hall, very interesting part of our museum, please. This is very interesting part of our museum. And in 1896, Alexander Polovtsev came to Tashkent, and he was ethnographer, and he liked our craft, handicraft, and that's why he invited from different parts of our countries very famous masters carving on Ganj, ceramist, painting on wood, and carving on wood also. And you can see the ceiling of the room painted with natural colors. Worked the master Tahir Takhta Hojaev, he was from Tashkent. And on the wall you can see more than 200 ornaments which didn't repeat second time, and ceramic tiles made master from Rishtan, Fergana Valley. He has own workshop in the middle of 19th century, which in his workshop came from different countries like Iran, like China, and learned to make the tiles. And in the middle it was the fountain from wood, and after in 1966 it restored with stones. For decoration only worked masters here during 8 years, from 1896 till 1904. And untraditional part of our room is ovens for heating the room. One of them made like Muslim mosque, and second like Russian church. And you can see it says about the house of diplomat. And on the doors you can see the words of the famous people who lived in 9th, 11th centuries in Tajik, in Arabic writing. Here you can see written this world palace with two doors from first people enter, from second entrance. And in the next you can see here written that in this world come different nations. And in this small room, you can see some works of the very famous painter, Chingiz Aitmatov, please. Here you can see a small room of restroom of the Alexander Polovtsev, and here decorated with paintings after independence in 1992. And these works made from the master, a very famous master painter of Kyrgyzstan and Uzbekistan, Chingiz Aitmatov. He worked during 5 years to finish this works from 1986 till 1991. And here you can see he introduced the very famous poet Alisher Navai with his teacher Abdurrahman Jami. And here you can see a master who makes national material which we call Honatlas. Honatlas means atlas is a material. Material for Han. You can see he shows for to the girls from palace because other people couldn't wear clothes from Honatlas, only women of palace. And here you can see dancer who dances in Nauruz holiday. And here you can see several girls makes embroidery for their diary, and from the window looks the man. And you can see here, as our country was the center of ceramics, here you can see ceramics makes on the pottery wheel different kind of the vases in palace also. And in our next room you can see porcelain and glasses, please. It was the library of Alexander Polovtsev, and you can see the ceiling. It didn't restore it till now, because in the central hall it were two times restoration. First restoration was in 1941 and second restoration was in 1961. But in this hall you can see the selling keeping during more than 120 years, like as it was. And here you can see porcelain and glasses from the poem of Alisher Navai, Sabbai Sayyot, which means seven beauties. He introduced seven beauties of seven Eastern countries. The works of Chingiz Akhmarov made Anvar Nugmanov, he was very famous master of Tashkent, on painting on porcelain. And in 1965 in Tashkent, in 1972 in Samarkand, there were founded the factories of porcelain. And in showcases you can see some examples which made in these factories. And this set we call Pakhtagul, which means cotton flower. As cotton, our traditional ornament, you can meet nowadays in everywhere, in each part of our country. And there are some glasses you can see. In 1980, it was founded in Tashkent, the glass factory. And in very high quality produced this kind of glasses. And but it's a pity nowadays it doesn't work, but some of the works of this factory we keep in our museum. Printing textile usually used for the decoration for the houses, as it was no furniture before. Different kind of suzanis, carpets and printing textile used for the decoration for the rooms. And you can see here special stamps which made by wood covers from apricot and pear tree, because these two kind of the tree, it's very nice for the color. And 6-7 of the stamps used for one panel, and some of them used two times with different colors. And colors also was a natural. And in these showcases you can see traditional musical instruments like Kashgar rubab, Afghan rubab, tar of Azerbaijan. And here you can see pair of nohora, we call nohora. And the base of the this instrument made of from ceramic, and then laser of cow used here. You in to the to making the musical instruments usually using animal lasers and mother of pearl, natural stones, and decorated with mother of pearl. Tashkent master made them. And these three musical instruments, puffle musical instrument, karnai, we call the long one, and the short one we call surnai, and the circle one we call doira. And before it used it to inform other people about change of palaces. And nowadays we cannot imagine without these three musical instruments our weddings. because it's you can hear the sound of Karnai from 2 kilometers, and it's invitation for the wedding party. And here you can see a vidjak made from the laser of fish. And here you can see tambur, dutar, and in dutar and in chaim played only women before, but to other musical instruments played men. Chaim played with special instruments that wear it on fingers, and then they could play it. Also decorated with mother of pearl. There is embroidery which made in machine, and in the middle of 20th century to Central Asia, people started to bring machine what makes embroidery, and it was very easy, and it was cheaper than handmade embroidery. If handmade embroidery took around 4 months, machine embroidery took 1 week by one woman. And it was cheaper, and people started to buy it and use it to, for the decoration for the houses. And nowadays also you can see so much of them in the bazaars. And here you can see boxes from papier-mâché, which made by masters of Tashkent, which worked in organization Usto. Usto means master. This organization was founded in Tashkent in 1980. And this kind of boxes using for the jewelry, for the making the gifts. And also national furniture you can see in our hall, which used for Quran. On book stand, usually used for the Quran and for the decoration for the houses. This hall is the carpets and wood carving. You can see three kind of the carpets here. First carpet we call julhers, which means the pile of beer from Arabic, and you can see with the long piles. And it used here wool of the animals, camel, goat, like sheep. And you can see horses of the animals, which means protection. Because usually the deserts, this kind of animals were, and looking to them, people thought about this kind of colors. Colors and the ornaments. And you can see carpets which we call gilam, carpets with a short pile. Sometimes this kind of carpets made by silk threads also. And some saddlebags you can see. Saddlebags, it's like modern suitcases, used for the clothes, for the products, for the dishes, and usually on horse, animal, or donkey, use this kind of saddlebags. And without any piles, we call palaces. And here you can see two examples of them. And the second part of our art here, wood carving. Wood carving of Khorezm, Kokand, Bukhara, and Tashkent masters. Usually for wood carving, use pear tree, apricot tree, oak tree, mulberry tree, karagach use it. And there are three techniques of the carving you can see on the pillars, which is from 19th century. You can see plant ornaments, which we call islimi. And on the doors, you can see second technique, which we call pargore, which is plant ornaments mixed with geometrical ornaments. This is example of pargore. And third one is screen shaped. And here you can see, we call it shabakha. And the work of master of Tashkent, which made in 1950. And here you can see more than 2,000 elements which didn't use glue, with each other made it like a puzzle. And here in showcase you can see small boxes of wood carving. And this is book stand. From one piece of the wood made this kind of without glue, only carving. And we call it a lal, which means book stand. And you can open it from 6 positions till 12 positions. And this hole, there are two kind of craft also, golden embroidery and jewelry art. Jewelry art of 19th, 20th century. Before, women wear this kind of jewelry around 5 kilograms for the parties, for the wedding. And here you can see, we call zebegardon, this jewelry. And then for the head, we call tellakosh. And pair of earrings, we call sirga. And pair of bracelet. Looking to the bracelet, also people knew the situation of woman. If it's pair of bracelet, it was the married woman. And decorated with natural stones like coral, turquoise, mother of pearl, used here. Usually silver used for the jewelry art, but some rich families also used golden. And this part, you can see golden embroidery. In the center of golden embroidery is Bukhara. Men only made this kind of golden embroidery, and at the end of the 20th century there were around 350 men who makes embroidery of gold. And usually also in the in thread you can see gold, real gold inside. And this panel we call Bayram, which means holiday. And here you can see 124 personages. Different kind of golden skull caps. After marriage, usually our girls wear this kind of skull caps during 40 days. It's our tradition, which is till now, we are keeping it. And small ones for the children, and square ones for the men. And some clothes for men and for women. Also shoes made from the gold embroidery. In this hall, you can see metal chasing and knives. Usually for daily using, our grandparents used this kind of metal chasing dishes. Usually this one. Guests usually, when come guests to the house, it's hand wash, which we call dashchui. And there is special water vessel, which we call oftoba. They waited for the guest with two this dishes, and it was the respect for the guest. And after they invited house, and you can see in our showcases three kind of the metal chasing also. First one we call chisma, till one millimeter carving we call chisma, which means drawn. And second we call kandakoro, which means carving till 5 millimeter carving. And third one is three-shaped. Here you can see, we call shabaka. This is elements of door. This is bell of the door. And this one was for women, for men, sorry. This for men. Usually we call it zulf. And this one we call halka. It's for women. From inside, women knew who came outside. If it's man, she called her husband. If it's woman, she answered herself. And from seven different metals made this kind of dish. And here you can see knives of our country from different parts of our country. From Shahrikhand, from Andijan, Chust, Bukhara, and Tashkent. The handle of the knives made from the animal bone and decorated with natural stones. And there is interesting knives which made in Tashkent by Nishanov. This is made from the elephant bone. And here you can see also the second knife. And usually it was the jewelry of men, and on belt usually they had this kind of knives. And looking to the handle, people knew from which family man. Thank you very much for your attention. Our museum located in Rakatboshi Street in Tashkent, the Museum of Applied Arts and the Handicraft History. Welcome to our museum again. Welcome to Uzbekistan. Nice to meet you. I think it's not your last visit to our country and to our museum. See you next time.